Good evening, boys and girls, and welcome to 5-Minute Bedtime Stories with Miss Elaine. I have another fun book to share with you this evening, and I'm actually going to dedicate it to my two friends, Isaac and Jackson. Isaac and Jackson, thanks so much for watching. I know your favorite story currently is Pete the Cat and the Bedtime Blues. I'm hoping you'll like this character maybe just as much. This is a cute little bird, Sleepy Bird, and he has a lot of spunk to him. Let's find out what happens in Sleepy Bird when this little guy does not want to fall asleep. It was bedtime, but Bird was not ready to go to sleep. His wings wanted to flap, his legs wanted to run, all of him wanted to play. "Whee!" said Bird. "It's party time!" It doesn't seem like party time, does it? It feels more like bedtime. But Bird just doesn't want to go to sleep. Fox was getting cozy when he heard Bird coming. "Goodness," said Fox, "that's a lot of noise for bedtime." "Well, I'm not tired," said Bird. "Maybe if you hugged my blankie," said Fox, "it helps me get sleepy." "Blanky schmanky," said Bird. "Let's play." But Fox was too sleepy to play, so Bird went to find Beaver. "It's bedtime, Bird," said Beaver. "Bedtime is for babies," said Bird. "How about I read you a story?" said Beaver. "How about you don't?" said Bird. He tapped Beaver on the arm. "Tag, you're it." Do you think Beaver wants to play it tag? I think Beaver's ready for bed too. Yeah. Bird ran to Rabbit's house, but Beaver didn't follow. "Everybody says it's bedtime," said Bird, "but I'm not tired." "Want to snuggle with my stuffed kitty?" asked Rabbit. "A stuffed cat?" said Bird. "Are you trying to give me nightmares?" Cats like to chase birds, don't they? So he doesn't want a stuffed cat. That's kind of scary to Bird. Bird went to find Raccoon. "Raccoon," said Bird, "you'll play with me, right?" "It's bedtime," said Raccoon. "I'm going to sing a soft lullaby and drift off to sleep."
"But you're nocturnal," said Bird. "Why won't anyone play?"
Bird flounced over to Sheep's place. "You know what you need," said Sheep. "New friends?" suggested Bird.
"You need to count sheep," said Sheep. "That always helps me fall asleep."
"But there's only one of you," shouted Bird. "How can you get sleepy counting to one?"
Bird stormed off. He was angry, wasn't he? Does he look mad? He sort of looks like his eyes are getting droopy. He sort of looks sleepy to me, too, like he might be getting there. But he's still pretty upset that nobody wants to play with him. If no one would play with him, he would just walk forever. That's what he's thinking. Well, after a little while, his wings drooped. His legs crumbled.
"I am not tired," he cried. "Why should I go to sleep?"
Now he even looks a little bit sad, huh? Do you see those tears falling from his eyes? I think maybe he's frustrated and he's sad and he's tired all at once. Even if he doesn't want to admit it, I think he's tired. Will he finally fall asleep? What do you think? Okay, let's keep reading to find out. Bird's friend heard his cries and they came running. Look, they're all coming to see what's the matter. They don't want Bird to cry. Fox covered Bird with his blankie. Beaver read a story. Rabbit tucked his stuffed kitty under Bird's wing. Raccoon sang a quiet song. Sheep counted herself until she got to one more times more than she could count. "I am not sleepy," mumbled Bird as he closed his eyes. Finally,
said his friends. I thought he'd never fall asleep, said Fox.
Did Sleepy Bird finally go night-night?
They lay down near Bird and slept. Bird rolled over. He opened his eyes. He yawned and stretched.
Hiya, chirped Bird. Who wants to play?
Oh my goodness. So he wasn't asleep after all, or he had a very, very short nap. He was up again, ready to play, and all his friends want to do is go to sleep. Oh my goodness.
Boys and girls, I hope you enjoyed that story, and Isaac and Jackson, I hope you did too.
We're going to sing our lullabies next, and I invite you, of course, to sing along with me. I'm going to show you my star, and I want you to put up your 10 wiggly fingers, because these can be your twinkle stars at home. Can you go like this? Perfect. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are.
Fantastic. Thanks for singing with me. Let's turn it over so that now you see my moon, right? And we're going to sing God Bless the Moon. Here we go.
I see the moon and the moon sees me. God bless the moon and God bless me.
And God bless you boys and girls at home. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon on 5 Minute Bedtime Stories with Missy Lane. Good night.